In experiments 6 and 7, we'll be addressing digital electronics. Up until this point, we've been working in the analog electronic world, where when you put a signal into the input of some black box like a filter or an operational amplifier, what comes out tracks the input, and also both the input and output functions are continuous. In the digital world, we essentially switch back and forth between two discrete states. In order to be able to switch between states, we need a switch. That's sort of an obvious thing to say, but that's the role of the transistor in a digital circuit. So we're going to be looking at, as I said, analog circuits versus digital circuits, which is this first topic. Bipolar junction transistors, which is the simplest and oldest form of the transistor, and indeed we'll be using that as our switch. We'll look a bit at transistor characteristics and transistors as switches. That's all in this first part of experiment 6. As I mentioned, an analog signal is a signal that whose value varies continuously over time. And we can see right in this region here, here's a function that's varying continuously. A digital signal can only take on discrete values. In this case, it shows that it's going from 0 to 50 to 100 to 150, but doesn't take on any of the values in between. Now, the most common digital signal is the binary signal, which is listed up here, which just switches back and forth between two states, a high state and a low state. And these are represented by the numbers 1 and 0. And so we will have binary arithmetic, where the only two numbers we actually use are 0 and 1. So binary voltage waveforms will switch back and forth between a high state and a low state. And for the BJT type transistors that we'll be dealing with, and on which we build something called transistor-transistor logic, the high state will be 5 volts and the low state will be 0 volts. So each time we see a voltage near 5 volts, we'll call that a 1, and anything near 0 volts, we'll call that a 0. We monitor the change in state by either monitoring the leading edge or the falling edge or the positive edge or the negative edge, whichever you want to call it. Okay, again, so that's the states that we're looking at. The device we're going to be using to switch is the bipolar junction transistor, which looks like this. It's typically in a plastic package with three legs on it. These legs are called the emitter, collector, and base. And I'm going to switch over to a different representation of this to give you a very, very high-level view of how the transistor works. Okay, here's the symbol of the transistor again, where we have the collector up here, we have the emitter, and we have the base. And the way you should think about the transistor, the very simplest way to think about it, is that there is a path for significant current flow from the collector to the emitter in this type of transistor. And the voltage on the base controls the ability of the transistor to transmit that current from the collector to the emitter. And so when we have no voltage on it, there's no way for the current to flow from the collector to emitter, and the switch between the collector and the emitter would be open. When we put a voltage on the base, there becomes a path. It's like opening a valve, and the current will be able to flow from the collector to the emitter. In effect, what happens here is something like this. Where the width of this little section here is controlled by this voltage. It's pinched off completely, then no current flows. When it's wide open, the same width as the upper and lower parts here, then lots of current flows. And in between, the current will only partially flow. And so you can control this and either go from a totally on state to a totally off state.